This is a true story about one of the Frisco Railroad's great firemen. An actual incident that occurred on the Frisco Railroad 5 miles west of Columbus, Kansas, in September of 1930. As the train rolled along, a very unusual thing happened. A tanker wanted to race. You heard the tunes of Casey Jones and the Wabash Cannonball Ball. And the Vagabond 97, but this one tops them all. In September, the night he settled in town, Frisco's Tommy Tucker faced the searing flag. Fire doors open wide, the shovel shining bright. Tommy's thoughts were of his home, he hoped to reach that night. The roar of the exhaust, the engine's pounding bright. His engineer leaned far from Jordan Cab, his eyes were open wide. They were 5 miles west of Columbus, the speed was 85. The highway ran along their track, the car was set on fire. The engine number 128 churned along the track, while fireman Tommy Tucker bent his aching back. The highway of Kerr's gas truck ran. Long Tommy's faithful engine, the beat it was a plan. Side to side, roared the two on the highway and on the track. Fireman shouted to his halter, we'll lead them way out back. But try as each could do, the two stayed side by side. Oh, 128's throttle set on open wide. Tommy Tucker shoveled coal as he never had before. We'll beat the more die trying, that trucks me a bore. Now up ahead the highway, across the railroad track. And as the two raced side by side, Tommy's train dropped a little back. The truck had reached the crossing, along with Tommy's train. Such a blast it rocked the land and parts began to rain. A tremor like never felt before shook up and down the track. Poor Tommy Tucker lent his flaming cap the brake lever through his back. The engine burned to a rusty red and up and down the line. Frisco people will remember the day that Tommy died. No braver fireman ever lived somewhere up above. Old Tommy's up there standing with the shovel in his glove. Couldn't let them beat us in that blasted parade. Since it turned into a draw, I sort of like this parade.